Blackstone Audio presents The Devil She Knows by Bill Loehfelm. For AC. 1. Blood. Maureen sniffed again at the dark smears on her fingertips. Pungent sweetness and a hint of iron. Definitely blood. Not the answer she had hoped for. But the fresh stains couldn't be anything else. She studied the spray pattern of red dots peppering the outside of her windowsill. That's the effect of sharp teeth, she thought, punching holes through skin. She hadn't seen or heard anything, a surprise since she'd left the kitchen only for a few moments to answer the phone. Nothing left of the body but what looked like sticky feathers. The culprit sat in plain sight. These attacks had to stop. You're killing me! She shouted out the window, down at the fire escape landing a floor below her kitchen. Narrow yellow eyes stared back at her, fearless and devoid of mercy or empathy. You're absolutely killing me, you fuzzy little prick! Maureen put the phone back to her ear, turning away from the window. And you are too, she said to her caller. You know that, don't you, Dennis? You're going to be the death of me. You better not call me fuzzy, Dennis said. I wouldn't know about that. Maureen headed to the kitchen counter. And I don't want to know. She grabbed a half-full beer bottle and carried it back to the window. All I know is I worked the past 5 nights. Reaching out the window, she emptied the beer bottle over the skinny calico on the fire escape landing. With one twitch of its tail, the cat launched onto the railing and away from the beer shower. The cat looked down at the beer, up at Maureen, and then sailed without a sound from the railing to the leafless bough of a nearby tree. A dozen sparrows hit the air, chirping in panic and warning. Sorry. Come on, Maureen, Dennis said, teetering on the edge of whining. I'm really stuck here. Help me out. Maureen sat at the kitchen table, jamming the phone between her ear and shoulder, crossing her ankles. You're totally murdering me. One more night might do me in, for real. She pulled a cigarette from the pack on the table and lit it, listening to the bar manager, her boss, apologize, and then beg some more. I'll tell you what's wrong with Tanya, Maureen said, in 3 words, O-P-ets. She's either too high or too sick from getting high to work. Don't believe that bullshit about her sinuses, please. Yeah, she told me she was done with it too, but you know better. We both do. Maureen leaned forward, pressing her forehead into her free hand. Okay, I'll come in, but not as a favor to you. I need the money. This is for me, not for Tanya, not for you. She disconnected and tossed the phone on the table. Well, so much for the gym. Good thing she had maxed out her credit card renewing the membership yesterday. Maureen got up from the table and went back to the window. Leaning out from the waist up, she grabbed the bird feeder and pulled it inside. She'd have to move it again. Taking the feeder down meant letting the cat win, and Maureen hated that. But it wasn't fair to make the neighborhood birds pay the tab for her pride. Eliminating the cat, which Maureen knew damn well she couldn't stomach, was the only other option. Besides, punishing the cat for doing what it was built to do wasn't fair either. I'm the person, she thought. It's my job to be smarter, to find the high road. She was sure a situation existed where cats could be cats, and birds could be birds, and everyone could go about their business in peace. She just had to find it. She set the feeder on the counter, silently promising to get it back outside in a cat-proof location as soon as possible. She couldn't let the situation linger. The birds needed her. Winter was coming.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.